Daily morning prayer, Wednesday, May 8, 2024. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in his presence, to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at his hands, to declare his most worthy praise, to hear his holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much to devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy law. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. Today be praised. Alleluia. Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. Rebuke me not, O God. Rebuke me not, O Lord, in your anger, neither chasten me in your weighty displeasure. For your arrows stick fast in me, and your hand presses me hard. There is no health in my flesh because of your displeasure. Neither is there any rest in my bones by reason of my sin. For my iniquities have gone over my head and are like a heavy burden, too much for me to bear. My wounds stink and fester by reason of my foolishness. I am brought into such great trouble and misery that I go about mourning all the day long. For my loins are filled with burning and there is no wholeness in my body. I am feeble and sorely smitten. I have roared because of the tumult of my heart. Lord, you know all my desire and my groanings. My groaning is not hidden from you. My heart is panting. My strength has failed me, and the sight of my eyes is gone from me. My friends and my neighbors turn away from my trouble, and my kinsmen stand afar off. Those also who seek after my life lay snares for me And those who go about to do me evil talk of wickedness and imagine deceit all the day long. As for me, I am like the deaf who do not hear, and as one who is mute, who does not open his mouth. I become like a man who hears not, and whose mouth are no reproofs. In you, O Lord, have I put my trust. You shall answer for me, O Lord my God. I have said, let not my enemies triumph over me, for when my foot slipped, they rejoiced greatly over me. Truly I am about to fall, and my pain is ever with me, for I will confess my wickedness and be sorry for my sin. But my enemies live and are mighty, and those who hate me wrongfully are mighty in number. Those also who repay evil for good are against me, because I follow that which is good. Forsake me not, O Lord my God. O be not far from me. Make haste to help me, O Lord God of my salvation. I said, I will take heed to my ways, that I may not offend with my tongue. I will keep my mouth as with a bridle, while the ungodly are in my sight. I held my tongue and spoke nothing. I kept silence, even from good words. But it was pain and grief to me. My heart was hot within me. And while I was thus pondering, the fire kindled. And at last I spoke with my tongue. Lord, let me know my end and the number of my days, that I may learn how short my life is. Behold, you have made my days as a span in length. My age is even as nothing before you, and truly everyone living is but a breath, for everyone walks about as a shadow and disquiets himself in vain. He heaps us riches and cannot tell who shall gather them. And now, Lord, what is my hope? Truly my hope is in you. Deliver me from all my offenses, and make me not a taunt of the foolish. I became mute and opened not my mouth, for it was you that brought it to pass. Take your affliction from me. I am consumed by the blows of your heavy hand. When you with rebukes chasten someone for sin, you consume what is dear to him like a moth eating a garment. Everyone therefore is but vanity. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and with your ears consider my cry. Hold not your peace at my tears, for I am a stranger with you, and a sojourner as with all, as all my fathers were. O turn your gaze from me, that I may again be glad, before I go away to be seen no more. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined to me and heard my call. He brought me out of the horrible pit, out of the mire and clay. He set my feet upon the rock and secured my footing. He has put a new song in my mouth, a song of thanksgiving unto our God. Many shall see and fear, and shall put their trust in the Lord. Blessed is the man who has set his hope in the Lord, and has not turned to the proud, or to those who go about lying. O Lord my God, great are the wondrous works which you have done, and also your thoughts toward us. There is none who can be compared with you. If I should declare them and speak of them, they would be more than I am able to express. Sacrifice and offering you do not desire, but my ears you have opened. Burnt offerings and sin offerings you have not required. And so I said, behold, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me that I delight to do your will, O my God. Indeed, your law is within my heart. I have declared your righteousness in the great congregation. Behold, I will not restrain my lips, O Lord, and that you know. I have not hidden your righteousness within my heart. My talk has been of your truth and of your salvation. I have not concealed your loving mercy and truth from the great congregation. Withdraw not your mercy from me, O Lord, that your loving kindness and your truth always preserve me. For innumerable troubles have encompassed me, and my sins have taken such hold of me that I am not able to look up. Indeed, they are more in number than the hairs of my head, and my heart has utterly failed me. O Lord, let it be your pleasure to deliver me. Make haste, O Lord, to help me. Let them be ashamed and confounded who seek after my soul to destroy it. Let them be driven backward and rebuked who wish me evil. Let them be desolate and rewarded with shame who say to me, Aha, aha. Let all those who seek you be joyful and glad in you, and let those who love your salvation say always, The Lord be praised. As for me, I am poor and needy, but the Lord cares for me. You are my helper, my deliverer. Do not tarry, O my God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy, beginning with the 9th chapter, the 1st verse. Hear, Israel, you are crossing the Jordan today to go in to dispossess nations greater and mightier than you, cities that are great and fortified to heaven, a people who are great and tall, the sons of the Anakim, whom you know and of whom you have heard it said. Who can stand against the sons of Anak? So be aware today that it is the Lord your God who is crossing over ahead of you as a consuming fire. He will destroy them and will subdue them before you so that you may drive them out and eliminate them quickly, just as the Lord has spoken to you. Do not say in your heart when the Lord your God has driven them away from you, because of my righteousness the Lord has brought me in to take possession of this land. Rather, it is because of the wickedness of these nations that the Lord is dispossessing them before you. It is not because of your righteousness or the uprightness of your heart that you are going in to take possession of their land, but it is because of the wickedness of these nations that the Lord your God is driving them out from before you. And in order to confirm the oath which the Lord swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Know then that it is not because of your righteousness that the Lord your God is giving you this good land to possess, for you are a stubborn people. Remember, do not forget how you provoked the Lord your God to anger in the wilderness. From the day that you left the land of Egypt until you arrived at this place, you have been rebellious against the Lord. Even at Horeb, you provoked the Lord to anger, and the Lord was so angry with you that he would have destroyed you. When I went up to the mountain to receive the tablets of stone, the tablets of the covenant which the Lord made with you, then I remained on the mountain for 40 days and nights. I neither ate bread nor drank water. The Lord gave me the 2 tablets of stone written by the finger of God, and on them were all the words which the Lord had spoken with you at the mountain from the midst of the fire on the day of the assembly. It came about at the end of 40 days and nights that the Lord gave me the 2 tablets of stone, the tablets of the covenant. Then the Lord said to me, Arise, go down from here quickly, because your people, whom you brought out of Egypt, have behaved corruptly. They have quickly turned aside from the way that I commanded them. They have made a cast metal image for themselves. The Lord also said to me, I have seen this people, and indeed it is a stubborn people. Leave me alone, that I may destroy them and wipe out their name from under heaven, and I will make you a nation mightier and greater than they. So I turned and came down from the mountain while the mountain was burning with fire, and the 2 tablets of the covenant were in my two hands, and I saw that you indeed sinned against the Lord your God. You had made for yourselves a cast metal image of a calf. You have quickly turned aside from the way that the Lord had commanded you. So I took hold of the two tablets and threw them from my two hands and smashed them to pieces before your eyes. Then I fell down before the Lord like the first time for 40 days and nights. I neither ate bread nor drank water because of all your sin which you had committed by doing what was evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. For I was afraid of the anger and the rage with which the Lord was angry with you, so as to destroy you. But the Lord listened to me at that time as well. And the Lord was also angry enough with Aaron to destroy him. So I also prayed for Aaron at the same time. And I took your sinful thing which you had made to calf, and burned it in the fire and crushed it, grinding it thoroughly until it was as fine as dust. And I threw its dust into the stream that came down from the mountain. Then at Taberah, at Masha, and at Kibroth Hatta'ava, you kept provoking the Lord to anger. And when the Lord sent you from Kadesh Barnea, saying, go up and take possession of the land which I have given you, you rebelled against the command of the Lord your God. You neither trusted him nor listened to his voice. You have been rebellious toward the Lord since the day I knew you. So I fell down before the Lord for 40 days and nights, which I did because the Lord said he would destroy you. And I prayed to the Lord and said, Lord God, do not destroy your people, your inheritance, whom you have redeemed through your greatness, whom you have brought out of Egypt with a mighty hand. Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Do not turn your attention to the stubbornness of this people, or to their wickedness, or their sin. Likewise, the people of the land from which you brought us will say, since the Lord was not able to bring them into the land which he had promised them, and since he hated them, he has brought them out to kill them in the wilderness. Yet they are your people and your inheritance, whom you brought out by your great power and your outstretched arm. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Rise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has dawned upon you. But behold, darkness covers the land, deep gloom and shrouds the peoples. But over you the Lord will rise, and his people, and his glory will appear upon you. Nations will stream to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawning. Your gates will always be open. By day or night they will never be shut. They will call you the city of the Lord, the Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Violence will no more be heard in your land, ruin or destruction within your borders. You will call your walls salvation, and all your portals praise. The sun will no more be your light by day. By night you will not need the brightness of the moon. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, beginning with the 6th chapter, the 1st verse. Now it happened that Jesus was passing through some grain fields on a Sabbath, and his disciples were picking the heads of grain, rubbing them in their hands, and eating them. But some of the Pharisees said, why are you doing what is not lawful on the Sabbath? And Jesus, answering them, said, Have you not even read what David did when he was hungry, he and those who were with him, how he entered the house of God and took and ate the consecrated bread, which is not lawful for anyone to eat except the priests alone, and gave it to his companions. And he was saying to them, "The Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." On another Sabbath, he entered the synagogue and taught, and a man was there whose right hand was withered. Now the scribes and the Pharisees were watching him closely to see if he healed on the Sabbath, so that they might find a reason to accuse him. But he knew what they were thinking, and he said to the man with the withered hand, "Get up and come forward." And he got up and came forward. And Jesus said to them, "I ask you whether it is lawful to do good on the Sabbath, or to do harm, to save a life, or to destroy it." And after looking around at them all, he said to him, "Stretch out your hand." And he did so, and his hand was restored. But they themselves were filled with senseless rage and began discussing together what they might do to Jesus. Now it was at this time that he went off to the mountain to pray, and he spent the whole night in prayer with God. And when day came, he called his disciples to him and chose 12 of them, whom he also named as apostles: Simon, whom he also named Peter, and his brother Andrew, and James, and John, and Philip, and Bartholomew, and Matthew, and Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus, and Simon, who is called the Zealot, and Judas, the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. And then Jesus came down with them and stood on a level place, and there was a huge crowd of his, and there was a large crowd of his disciples, and a great multitude of the people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the coastal region of Tyre and Sidon, who had come to hear him and to be healed of their diseases. And those who were troubled by unclean spirits were being cured. And all the people were trying to touch him, because power was coming from him and healing them all. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins, the tender compassion of our God. The dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, Lord of heaven and earth, we humbly pray that your gracious providence may give and preserve to our use the harvests of the land and of the seas, and may prosper all who labor to gather them, that we, who are constantly receiving good things from your hand, may always give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as surpass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, you have brought us safely to the beginning of this day. Defend us by your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin nor run into any danger, and that guided by your Spirit, we may do what is righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, send down upon our clergy and the congregations committed to their charge the life-giving Spirit of your grace. Shower them with the continual dew of your blessing, and ignite in them a zealous love of your gospel. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offences, nor the offences of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine. Good Lord, deliver us from all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us by the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation. Good Lord, deliver us by your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial. Good Lord, deliver us by your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory. Good Lord, deliver us in all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment. Good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. Beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servant, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. The Blessed God, all judges, give them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. The Blessed keep our armed forces by sea and land and air to shield them at all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Bless and protect all who serve the communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Make wars to cease in all the world and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless, and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To preserve all who are in danger by reason of the work of travel, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To have mercy upon all people, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. That it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. To grant that we may attain to your heavenly kingdom, we beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days, and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Who our enemies, defend us, O Christ, graciously. Behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts. Blessedly forgive the sins of your people. With favor, hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure. And grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, and the means of grace, and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.